Minister Peter Lokeris notes that the rural power connection under the Scalar project will help boost economic activities like welding, grinding and saloon, among others. He asked the communities to protect the power lines, describing those vandalizing as enemies of government.
I appeal to the communities, protect your lines. There should not be any vandalization of the power lines. Those people are causing us trouble, disrupting health services and so on. In fact, we take them as our enemies, number one, who are going to disrupt the progress and development of our country.
Under the Scalar project, government has earmarked ceiling $638 million, which will help connect rural communities that have not been connected to power. He, however, said the 132 kV power from National Grid for Industrial Development for West Nile from Oluyo to West Nile is due and will spread in the region and cross to South Sudan.
Those lines who have not been energized, they are all going to be energized. So this is now when you are going, you are already seeing power here, and we are continuing. And we are doing it throughout the country. This one here, first of all, can use this small project, grinding this one sufficient. But for industrial purposes, the line is coming from Oluyo. It will come up here, bringing 132 kV for industrialization.
The Royal Norwegian Embassy Ambassador to Uganda, Ann-Kristin Hermansen, said Norway has cooperated with Uganda for decades in various areas, with energy development as a priority. This helps the economic development of the refugees and host communities through access to power.
Access to energy is a prerequisite for economic growth and for development. And we believe that assisting the refugee communities so that refugees can also create businesses and benefit the local communities together with the host communities, which is important. And I believe that this is going to make a difference.
Commissioning of this power will help us a lot, most especially the community in the church. It will help us when someone dies, we are going to use this power. It will help those who are readers, reading the Bible.
For myself, I plan to open a saloon, a trading center. And then I also plan to bring machines for photocopy, whereby I'll have a room here. And I open that room, I do my photocopy here.
Sarifa Ate, the woman member of parliament for Koboko District, asked government to extend electric poles to institutions that have not benefited, citing health facilities and schools as priority.
That most of our sub-county headquarters are in darkness. That our hospitals and schools are still in darkness. That my hospital, Barifa, needs poles. Wenireko, are you hearing? We need poles because very soon an x-ray machine is going to be brought there. And you know how our people have been suffering without a proper x-ray.
James Baba, the MP for Koboko County, commended the Norwegian government and its people for extending financial support to Uganda, which has helped increase the rural electricity connection with consideration of the refugee hosting communities.
I also want to thank Excellency the Norwegian Ambassador. Through her, the government Norway decided that the power should be brought in an area which hosts refugee communities.
Lobule sub-county is hosting Congolese refugees and benefited from the power with support from the Norwegian government through Government of Uganda. A report compiled by Robert Ariaka for the news.